What's up internet, welcome back once again. I am Manish from rebellionrider.com. Now that we are done with the introduction to bulk collect, it's time to take a step ahead and learn how to use PLSQL bulk collect clause with select into statement in Oracle database. So far we learned that bulk collect is all about reducing the overhead caused by the context switches to increase the efficiency of the query. Let's try to understand what does that mean. Here we have a PLSQL program. The execution section of this program consists of a SQL operation, and that SQL operation is a select statement. This select statement is retrieving all the data from the column first name of the employees table and storing it into the collection which we created in the declaration section of the same program. In my case, there are 107 records in the employees table. It may be different in your case. When we will execute this program, PLSQL runtime engine will execute all the PLSQL statements. But as soon as it will come across as any SQL operation, it will transfer the control to the SQL runtime engine. SQL engine will then process the statement and return the result back to the PLSQL engine. In our case, that SQL operation is the select statement which is retrieving all the first names from the employees table. And as I mentioned earlier, there are total 107 records in my employees table, which means the control will jump 107 times from PLSQL engine to SQL engine and 107 times from SQL engine to PLSQL engine. In total, there will be 214 control jumps between PLSQL and SQL runtime engines. As we have learned in previous tutorial, the higher the hopping of controls, the greater will be the overhead, which in turn will degrade the performance. This means that we need to find an option which can reduce those control jumps between the engines. That option is the bulk collect clause. Bulk collect clause compresses multiple switches into a single context switch, which in turn improves the performance of the query. So let's move ahead and modify this code and learn how to use bulk collect clause with select into statement. Before that, let me clear one thing. This is a dummy code which on execution will raise an error because we cannot use locally created collection with a SQL statement as we are doing here. I have used this code just to make you all understand what is context switching and how it works. Now we will modify this code and make it work, and that too with bulk collect clause. Let's do that. Here is our completely modified as well as optimized PLSQL bulk collect code. I also assure you that this time it will work. But before executing it, let's first see what we did here. The declaration section is still the same. It contains only a local PLSQL collection, which is a nested table, and a corresponding collection variable of our nested table type. You can refer to my PLSQL tutorial 51 to learn how to work with PLSQL nested table in Oracle database. All the links are in the description. Then we have the execution section. Inside this section, we have a select into statement. This statement is again retrieving all the records from the first name column of the employees table. But this time, right before the into keyword, we have specified the bulk collect clause, which completely changes the game here. This single clause alone changes the whole execution process of this code. Let me tell you how. On the execution of this program, when PLSQL engine comes across the SQL operation, it will club all the 107 context switches together into one single context switch and send it to the SQL engine in a single go instead of transferring them individually to the SQL engine and vice versa. It means this time instead of 214 switches, we will only have two context switches, one from PLSQL to SQL and one from SQL to PLSQL engine. And all this thanks to the mighty bulk collect clause. Let's also add a loop which will print the data which this select into statement is fetching from the employees table and storing into the collection nt_fname. So that we can see how many records we have retrieved from the table. Here we have our for loop, which will be printing all the elements which we just fetched into the collection. Now let's execute this code and see the output. But before that, I'll take a quick second to ask you to hit that thumbs up button and like this video. Your every single like keeps me motivated for creating more such interesting tutorial. Also, do make sure to subscribe as many such videos are yet to come. That being said, let's go ahead and execute this PLSQL program. Here is our result. As you can see, we have successfully retrieved 107 records from the employees table. We can further fine-tune this code with the help of cursors, which gives us a strong control on our query that we will cover in the next tutorial. So stay tuned, as in the next tutorial, we will learn how to use bulk collect with PLSQL cursor to optimize the performance of the query. That's it for today. Hope this tutorial helped you in learning how context switches occur and what is their impact on the performance of the query. Also, how we can use bulk collect to overcome the overhead caused by the context switch and enhance the performance of the PLSQL query. This is the tutorial on bulk collect clause with select into statement. Thanks for watching. This is Manish from RebellionWriter.com.